Hi, I'm Duncan. I'm the technical trainer at Enphase, and today I'm going to show you how to complete efficient commissioning of grid-connected Enphase IQ8 microinverters for a solar PV-only site. Now, it's important to note that the installer app commissioning process is different if you're installing IQ batteries or other system components. To begin commissioning an Enphase PV-only system, you will require the IQ gateway and internet access on your phone. All installations use an IQ gateway installed, for example, in a solar switchboard for communications and control. You also have two options for the IQ gateway device. You can use the traditional IQ gateway that is installed into a solar subboard. This will also include IQ relays for each of the microinverter circuits. Or you can use the IQ system controller, which has a built-in IQ gateway. IQ system controllers can be used to ensure the site is IQ battery ready should the homeowners decide to add battery storage in the future. If you already have the Enphase installer app downloaded on your phone or tablet, check to make sure it's up to date. Now jump into the App Store or Google Play for the latest version. You'll also need internet access on your device. You will need to connect the IQ gateway to your customer's internet. You can do this via Ethernet cable or Wi-Fi. If you choose Wi-Fi, you need your customer's Wi-Fi password. Switch on the IQ gateway and confirm that the installation is ready for commissioning. As it powers up, the LEDs will flash red for a couple of minutes. You are now ready to commission, so open up your app and follow the screen prompts to log in. If you do not have an account, register for free online via the Enphase website. I recommend checking out the video library in the support tab where you can view videos on all the commissioning stages. If you ever get stuck, simply return to this section for additional support. Also, before you begin commissioning, always be sure to check the app settings. Here you can confirm that you have the latest software to enable commissioning of your IQ8 microinverters and IQ gateway. Check for software version 8 or higher for IQ8 microinverters. Update if the button shows orange. Also check that auto download over cellular is switched on. Next, for IQ8 microinverters to power up and operate, it is critical to select the correct grid profile. You will require minimum version 1.3.7 of grid profile. Select from the list and then select update. Now return to the systems tab and let's begin commissioning. Now I'm going to take you through the first step, system details. When adding IQ8 microinverters to an existing system, find the site name on the list. But note, if the site already has microinverters, you will be adding a new IQ gateway or IQ system controller with the IQ8 microinverters. You will commission these independently of the existing site installation. You will see how to add these devices in stage 2. Otherwise, for a new system, press the plus button to the bottom right and create a brand new site, then add site details. In stage 2, you're programming the device serial numbers. I will show you a quick, simple method for scanning Enphase devices. Follow the prompts to begin adding devices. To begin, add one IQ gateway. Next, add the number of microinverters. And only add IQ relays as required. Then select continue. Find and scan the serial number for each device as prompted. A simple way to scan microinverters is to scan the serial number stickers placed on an array map. Now you have the option to create the array. You can also choose to build this online after commissioning is completed. To build the array on site, follow the screen prompts to create the virtual array used for remote panel level monitoring. Add array and number of panels, tilt angle, direction of the panels. Now name the array. Select the correct serial number for each microinverter and add it into each panel location. Then press save. Now press the back arrow and follow the screen prompts to add the IQ relay if required. Stages 1 and 2 are now completed and you're ready to go into stage 3. Press connect. You must now set up access point or AP mode connection to the IQ gateway. Select connect. Follow screen prompts to connect your phone's Wi-Fi to the IQ gateway. Now join the Wi-Fi network of the IQ gateway. wait for the IQ Gateway performance update to complete. My phone is now connected to the IQ Gateway. Now connect the IQ Gateway to the internet. If you choose to connect via Wi-Fi instead of Ethernet, you will need to find the customer's Wi-Fi network and enter their password to connect. There is now a red cross indication, meaning my phone does not have internet connection. This is the correct outcome. This is because I'm directly connected to the IQ Gateway using the phone's Wi-Fi. The screen indicates the phone is connected to the IQ Gateway, and this in turn is connected successfully to the internet via the customer's modem. And you can see the IQ Gateway is now applying a software update. The installer app is now updating the latest software for the devices. Please note, IQ8 microinverters must be updated to software version 8 or above. This task must be completed to successfully commission. Let's move on to stage 4, device provisioning. Now select Start Provisioning Devices. Provisioning sends any required updates and grid profiles to all the devices. It may take a few moments to complete, and you may choose to wait until each device shows that provisioning is completed. Then click Continue. You're now up to stage 5, system validation, to enable CT metering. Select the number of phases of solar that are wired to the IQ Gateway from the solar array. If you are new to Enphase commissioning, you can also choose to run through the metering wizard, which will give you detailed step-by-step checks to confirm the CT reading is as you would expect. Select No, I'm an expert to turn on the CT and view the readings. Now check the power reading. If it shows 0 watts, then you need to ensure that the IQ8s have the correct software version, that you have selected the correct grid profile, and the microinverter circuits have been turned on. Now enable production meter and proceed to consumption metering. Select the number of phases. And again, choose No, I'm an expert if you want to proceed directly to the metering screen. The consumption meter will read the loads consumed in the home and measure any solar export. Therefore, the consumption meter will be installed on the line side of the main switchboard, allowing you to monitor loads with solar, commonly known as net metering. Now you can turn on known loads. Before you press enable, be sure to confirm that the reading looks correct. The value should always be positive and the power factor should be 1 or close to 1. If the power factor is very low, say for example 0.3, check your wiring for correct phase connections. This is always a good measurement to check, especially in multi-phase installations. Now press enable consumption meter. Meter configuration is now complete. Press continue, and we can be confident the wiring is correct and the measurements are good. Now let's go through the final stage, which is post-commissioning. Press Verify CT. You can now view the IQ Gateway summary, which you can also save or email using the icon on the top right of the screen. Press continue to disconnect from the IQ Gateway, and you're ready to complete the final step. The homeowner walkthrough guides you through all of the information helpful to share with the system owner. Finally, press confirm. And congratulations, your system commissioning of IQ8 microinverters is now complete. You can keep viewing the system data via the Enphase installer platform. Your customer will receive an email from Enphase with details on how to log in to the Enphase app. So you've completed commissioning, well done, and thanks for watching.